Hi, viewer, and welcome to the future. The OpenSky MO2J is an experimental jet-powered aircraft that is the first of seven futuristic flying machines that we have researched for this video. Based on the MEV or MEVE from the Japanese animated classic Nausicaä of the Valley of the Wind, the OpenSky was built by an art professor from Tokyo University named Kazuhiko Hachiya. Hachiya was inspired by the flight patterns of the MEV, and after building multiple scale models, he partnered with aeronautical engineers to build his version of the jet-powered single-person glider. Propulsion is handled by a jet engine originally designed for unmanned target drones, and the wingspan is quite wide, coming in at 31 feet and 7.3 inches. The max speed during flight is 56 miles per hour, and the max climbing rate is 490 feet per minute. To date, Hachiya has made over 220 flights and is the only pilot to attempt flying his creation. Jetpack Aviation Speeder. Coming up next is Jetpack Aviation's forthcoming recreational speeder. Dubbed the world's first flying motorcycle, this futuristic flying machine will be the first turbine-powered, fully stabilized personal takeoff and landing vehicle ever built. Fully stabilized is the key word here and means that the aircraft will always center itself and remain upright. Two trim options will be available for the speeder, the ultralight and experimental versions. The ultralight version will require no pilot's license to operate and will feature heavy fuel capacity and speed restrictions. Training will be provided by the Jetpack Aviation team at their headquarters. The experimental version, on the other hand, will require a pilot's license to operate, but will have no fuel capacity or speed restrictions. Lift is achieved by four turbine engines mounted to the center of the craft that deliver 705 pound-feet of thrust and a top speed of 150 miles per hour. The brand states the maximum elevation is 15,000 feet, but I'm not really sure that I'd want to fly this speeder at that high of an elevation, especially since the max flight time is a mere 20 minutes. Cirrus G2 Plus Vision Jet. The next futuristic flying machine is a single-engine personal jet by Duluth, Minnesota-based Cirrus Aircraft. The Cirrus G2 Plus Vision Jet is the latest and greatest personal jet on the market. Able to carry one crew member and six passengers with a maximum payload capacity of 1,328 pounds, it is the evolution of the original Vision Jet, which was released back in 2016. The G2 Plus has a 20% increase in takeoff performance, as well as increased payload and range capacity. The maximum cruise speed is 358 miles per hour, and the range is 690 miles with a 1,200 pound payload, or 1,381 miles with a 200 pound payload. Basically, if it's just the pilot on board. It also features luxurious reclining seats, comfortable legroom for 5 adults and 2 children, and a whole airframe parachute system that deploys in case of emergencies. There are more than 265 Vision Jets currently in service today, and the price tag for this version is about $3 million. Airspeeder MK3. Move over, NASCAR. Here comes flying race cars. Airspeeder is a newly formed manned electric vertical and takeoff landing vehicle racing league. If this seems too futuristic, just know that they recently completed the first ever airborne drag race. In the race, a pair of Airspeeder MK3s raced at an altitude of 50 feet for a length of about 1,000 feet. The winning flying car achieved a top speed of 96 miles per hour. The race was part of a preseason event to promote their full racing series to be held at their headquarters in Adelaide, Australia. Each Airspeeder MK3 and MK4 can reach 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.3 seconds. That's basically as quick as a Lamborghini Huracan or a Tesla Model 3. And they have a top speed of 100 miles per hour thanks to the 400 kilowatt motors that deliver over 540 horsepower. If you'd like us to keep an eye on this niche racing series, comment below with the hashtag Airspeeder. Hoverbike Scorpion 3. Our next futuristic flying machine is from Russian-based quadcopter company Hoversurf. Combining traditional motorcycle design and quadcopter technology, the Hoverbike Scorpion 3 is a rideable drone with a 229-pound load capacity and a 43-mile-per-hour top speed. The altitude limit is governed to 33 feet, and the total flying range is 13 miles, or roughly 20 to 40 minutes of flying time. The battery can be fully recharged in as little as 3 hours or swapped out in a matter of minutes. As a caveat, did you know that the Scorpion 3 became quite popular after the Dubai Police Force released video footage demonstrating how it may be utilized to monitor highly traveled areas? Pretty crazy, right? With a sturdy build and manageable controls, the Scorpion 3 is a great concept for anyone looking to explore their surroundings from a new perspective. However, it isn't currently available for purchase. If interested, there is a waiting list for those interested in becoming a beta tester. Maker by Archer Aviation. Archer Aviation, a Palo Alto-based company, has created a futuristic flying machine named the Maker. The Maker is an electric vertical takeoff and landing vehicle that features 12 independent motors, a 75 kilowatt-hour battery pack, which is about the same size battery pack as a Tesla Model 3 long range has, and a promised range of about 60 miles when cruising at a top speed of 150 miles per hour. The goal of the Maker and Archer Aviation is to explore the future of affordable and safe urban air mobility. And with the successful first flight under its belt, it looks like they're well on their way. So what's next for the Maker? According to Archer Aviation CEO and co-founder Edwin Shaw, we will now be moving into the manufacturing phase and are targeting a 2022 delivery to our first customers. Now before we get to number one, we are really hoping to get to 20,000 subscribers. So if you enjoy futuristic content on urban mobility and e-bike related topics like this, please consider subscribing. It really does help us out. All you have to do is turn that subscribe button from red to gray. Now, on to number one, Jetson 1. And now for the eVTOL that nearly broke the internet when it was released a few months back. And if you didn't know, of course I'm talking about the Jetson 1 by Swedish company Jetson. Jetson is one of the biggest competitors in the flying car space. That's because, unlike other companies in the eVTOL industry, Jetson's ambition is to sell their vehicles to individuals rather than trying to build out an extensive air taxi system. And at the somewhat achievable price of $92,000, they appear to have already found their market. Classified as an ultralight aircraft, meaning it is perfectly legal, albeit terrifying, the Jetson 1 can be flown in the US without a pilot's license or any real exhaustive training. However, if you can't afford one, your purchase comes with a 2-day training course to be conducted at the Jetson headquarters. The flight time is roughly 20 minutes for pilots weighing up to 210 pounds, and the batteries can be recharged in 1 hour via a 240 volt outlet or 2 hours via a standard 110 volt outlet. The 2021 and 2022 production runs are completely sold out, but the company is currently taking orders for 2023. So if you want to get your hands on a Jetson 1, be sure to make your reservation now. Many eVTOLs and other futuristic flying machines are currently in the concept phase, but will they one day be commonplace? Will we see them whisking around overhead during our daily commutes? We here at The Future will keep an eye on this industry and report back to you what we find. And in the meantime, I've created another video to inform you of other urban air mobility and eVTOL concepts. I think it really would be beneficial if you checked it out right now.